Is this the best budget dual narrowband OSC filter? Well, I think so. This is SV Bonnie's new SV220 dual band nebula filter. I've had the joy of using this for some nights now, and in this video I will give you my thoughts on whether you should get this or not. To be very upfront, I think this filter is the best bang for your buck in terms of 7nm dual narrowband filters. I'll tell you why and show you some images taken with it. Maybe you've never heard about dual narrowband filters. Let me tell you that these filters are essentially light pollution dual band filters designed to drastically reduce the effect of light pollution. They are essentially your light pollution filters, but on steroids. So how this filter works is that it isolates only two nebula wavelengths, hydrogen alpha, HA, and O3, and skips on all other wavelengths. This results in you maximizing on good wavelengths and aggressively minimizing all other wavelengths, including light pollution wavelengths. So with this filter, you will block the light pollution, maximize nebula signal, and make the sky background pitch black. This filter works well under bright urban skies and destroys the sky glow. Another great thing about this new filter is that it has very narrow FWHM. The thing to watch out for when buying filters is to see how narrow the FWHM is. The narrower the better, the smaller the number, the better it is. Well, this filter is 7nm, which is reasonably narrow. A bit like Optolong's L-Extreme. But unlike L-Extreme, this filter doesn't produce as bad star halos. I own L-Extreme and it makes me very sad because almost around every bright star there is a halo. But with this new filter from SV Bonnie, your star halos are very minimal and manageable. Yes, it does produce star halos, but they are so less compared to L-Extreme, which is amazing and bizarre because L-Extreme will cost you twice or three times more than this new SV Bonnie filter. Another awesome thing about this filter is that you can use this while the moon is out. Narrowband filters are least affected by moon. It's frustrating when you have a very few clear nights, but then you have moon glaring down, making it hard to image. Well, this filter does help and makes it easier to do astrophotography even when the moon is out. Let me show you the picture that I took with this filter. This is the image of the Horsehead Nebula. It's about 70 frames, 2 minutes each. I live in Portal 8 skies and I love how the Horsehead Nebula pops out while the background is crisp black and charcoal-y. Yes, there are halos, but minimum compared to L-Extreme. Here's another image. This is Carina Nebula. It's about 84 frames, again, 2 minutes each. And this is one of my favorite targets, and I love how this new filter has popped this image as well. It really does a great job. In short, I love this filter. It's way better than my L-Extreme, both in price and quality. This filter is designed for color OSC cameras. That means it will work on any color camera. It can work on DSLRs and astronomy color cameras. It will help you block the artificial lights from mercury vapor lamps, both high and low pressure sodium vapor lights, and the unwanted natural light caused by neutral oxygen emission in our atmosphere, whilst maximizing the transmission of good wavelengths. So this filter is highly recommended. Well, if you found this video to be helpful, please subscribe. If you have any questions, please write down in the comments below and I'll get back to you as soon as I can.